slipped. He hasn't got major congestion or anything like that. He's looking at us. He's listening to my voice, reassuring himself that there's no threats. Now these are the animals. These are the animals that were almost hunted to extinction 150 years ago by the sealers. The sealers were interested primarily, almost exclusively, with their skins and their coats. Their coats are very, very thermally effective, very waterproof, and very useful.
Oh, I should have caught
that! They're very good for making waterproof clothing. These aren't sea lions, these are big animals. The biggest is probably about 300 kilos. If you have a look closely at the shell closest to us, or whatever you've been listening to me, you've got little ears, see his small ears? A very good hearing, that's how you identify the Australian fur seal. You can see one on the left, see the young one that has jumped up on, see he's got bifurcated flippers, he's got a horizontal. These are air-breathing marine mammals. Air-breathing marine mammals have horizontal tails. Fish have vertical tails. All these animals, seals, dolphins, whales, orcas,
yes, scuba,
have horizontal tails. Mermaids have horizontal tails, so you can remember them, right? Now, the horizontal tail is very, very useful. It means to say these guys can accelerate rapidly through the water to escape predators. It also means these guys have got a bifurcated tail. Their tail is splitting apart. You can see this big guy close to us here. With that tail, they can scramble up on the structure because they can actually climb and walk on these things. That's quite important because if the weather gets very, very bad, these guys got a very, very good sensory perception for changes in barometric pressure. They can tell the weather better than Channel 7 and a few guys on TV. They know exactly what's going to happen. If the weather's going to get bad, they'll scramble up on these rocks and they'll get their young up onto these rocks and structures away from the waves.